So friends, today we will look into how we can improve the speed and performance of any computer, especially the laptop. So there are two aspects where you can look into for improving the performance. One is the hardware, another is the software. Software is currently not the scope of this video. In the hardware, you can upgrade the motherboard or CPU or GPU, or you can increase the RAM, or you can change the disk to improve the performance. Now, in case of the laptop, changing the motherboard, CPU and GPU is not really the possibility, because laptop comes in the fixed form factor. You don't have much of the options to make changes. Yes, of course, you can increase the RAM, so you have options of some laptops. Nowadays the laptops come with DDR3 RAM. Usually they are bundled with 4 GB of memory. You can increase that to 8 GB of memory. The most important part that we are looking today is the disk. What are the changes that you can make to the disk so that the performance increases multifold? Actually, not many people know about the special kind of the disk which is available, which is called as SSD, which stands for solid state drive. This SSD can drastically change the performance of your laptop. SSDs are the drives which are best suited for the laptops. We'll look into the details how SSDs are the best drives. So we are classifying the disk into three formats. One is classic 3.5 inch HDD, which is hard disk drive. It runs at 7200 RPM. Such kind of the disk is used in the desktop computer. Then we have 2.5 inch HDD. It's also hard disk drive, but it runs at 5400 RPM. And the third kind of the classification that we will be looking into is the SSD. That comes in 2.5 inch. It doesn't have any RPM because there's nothing rotating inside in that. There is no platter or no disk exactly inside in that. 7200 RPM, usually it generates more heat, it consumes more power, and it gives good amount of the performance. But when you come to the laptop, you cannot afford to generate lot of heat or consume power, because you want to keep the computer, your laptop, portable while you are moving. It should give you a lot of power, which can last, battery power which can last for the entire day. So that is why the lesser RPM disks are used on the laptop. They generate the less heat, they consume less power, but accordingly they also perform much lesser than the 7200 RPM disk. Now when we come to the SSDs, they do not have any RPM. SSDs do not have any RPM. There is nothing rotating inside in it. These are just microchips. They are able to save your data. They generate lesser heat. They consume lesser power, but they give the best of the performance. Now, the only thing which will not be in your favor is they are going to cost you a lot compared to the hard disk drive, because they use advanced technology. They are microchips. So we'll look into how exactly these drives look. So this is 3.5 inch. This is 3.5 inch hard disk drive, which is used in the desktop computer. It is big. And when it comes to the laptop, we use just 2.5 inch disk, which is like this. It is so small. And we are going to look into the SSD. We are going to unbox this. The SSD is going to be the same size of 2.5 inch, but the way it is going to perform is going to be much better. So here's Samsung SSD 850 Pro. This is powered with VNAND technology. This is what I ordered from Amazon. It came for about 10,000 rupees, and this has the capacity of 256 GB. So as SSD stands for solid state drive, this is going to boost the performance of the laptop, and we are going to unbox it. We'll see what exactly comes inside in it. So let's just open it. So here's the solid state drive. the SSD. It's Pro model. This is a Pro model. It comes with the red or brown dot over here. It is quite same like any other 2.5 inch hard drive. This is SSD, this is hard drive, this is HDD and this is SSD. So usually your laptop which comes from the company, from Dell or Lenovo or from HP, it comes with these kind of the drives. And this is much lightweight. It is going to consume much lesser power. It is not going to heat that much. So we'll see what else is there in the box. So there's a envelope attached to this. We'll try to remove, or we'll just open it from here. So it has installation guide, it has stickers, and there's warranty statement, some details, and there's a CD. So you must be wondering why they have bundled the CD. So what you can do with this CD is you can actually migrate your old hard drive contents to the SSD, and you don't need to do the reinstallation of the operating system and transfer all the files. Let's say if you have already installed the Windows and you have a lot of files already stored on your existing hard drive, you can transfer all those files along with the operating system to this new SSD and then just insert this into your laptop, and you just migrate it to the new disk drive. Sounds so simple, but you just cannot take out the drive and transfer the contents to the new disk drive. What you need is you need to separately buy the enclosure. So this is the old enclosure. It is USB 2. Nowadays you get USB 3 enclosure for the 2.5 inch drives. Using this kind of the enclosure, you can transfer the contents from existing laptop to this new SSD. So what this enclosure does is, this enclosure provides the interface to the USB. So what you need to do is, you need to put this SSD drive inside the enclosure, and now this becomes like an external hard drive. So you transfer all your contents from the existing laptop into this using the software which is bundled on the CD. And once it's everything is transferred, what you need to do is you need to install this SSD inside the laptop. And your old hard drive which you take out from the laptop, you can use this enclosure to make it as an external hard drive. There are two manual installations which are explained here. One is for the desktop PC and another one is for the laptop. So in case of the laptop, you need to have this enclosure to transfer all your contents from laptop to the SSD which came. So you need to have an enclosure. You install your SSD inside the enclosure, install the software which is one-stop install navigator into your laptop. Once it's installed, plug this enclosure into USB of the laptop, transfer all your data. Once all your data is transferred into the SSD, you can open the laptop and install this new hard drive, and then your laptop is switched to the new solid state drive and performs much faster.
So once you have transferred all the data from the laptop to the SSD, that is done the cloning of your hard drive in the laptop to the SSD, you can unplug the SSD and you can install the cloned SSD into your laptop in the hard disk compartment. Now before you install, make sure that you have removed the battery so that it is safe, and then you can unscrew the compartment where you usually upgrade the RAM and hard drive. So you can see there's a hard drive compartment, there's a compartment for the RAM. What you need to do is take out the HDD and install the cloned SSD inside in this. Before you take out the HDD, you need to remove the screws. Now this is little tricky. You have removed the screws, you cannot take out the hard drive as it is, because here's the slot where your hard drive is plugged. So there's a tape provided here, plastic tape. You need to pull it backward to take this hard drive from the compartment, and then pull it a little bit upwards and then bring it out. So there are two screws, you need to remove these two screws. So this is the small unit which has a plastic tape which can help you to pull the hard drive into the slot. So once we have taken out the HDD, we can install the SSD by first attaching the SSD to this unit and then inserting this unit inside in the laptop. So we'll take out the SSD. So this is the cloned SSD. We'll see, like, we can insert in this way. So once you have applied the screws to this aluminum unit, what you can do is you can go vertical and first push this SSD backward, and then with this plastic strap you can plug the SSD inside in this unit. So once it's plugged, there are two more screws to be applied here. And then you can just pack it. So now that we have installed the SSD inside in the laptop, we can put the battery back in the laptop. And now our laptop is ready with the SSD, and it's going to perform much faster. We'll see that into the test results.